One of the big challenges in treating brain diseases, including neurodegenerative diseases, is that we don't understand the system very well. We don't understand the types of cells that make up functional circuitry or the supporting cells that help to keep them healthy.
Our current understanding of what Alzheimer's disease does to the brain is that there's accumulation of toxic molecules that ultimately cause the cells to become sick, and the result of this is dementia. So what really is needed and what is lacking is an understanding of the earliest changes in disease before these toxins start to accumulate.
We now have some new tools which allow us to understand how many kinds of cells there are and what their properties are. Those same tools can now be used to ask what are the properties of the cells and which types of cells are affected in the course of Alzheimer's disease to get a much finer grained understanding of the disease itself and where it begins.
Right now we have sort of a 30,000 to 20,000 foot understanding of what happens in Alzheimer's disease in the human brain. Our hope with this center is that we can bring that down much closer to Earth. We're really fortunate in Seattle to have the Kaiser Permanente Washington Research Institute, the UW Medicine with multiple different departments and expertise in Alzheimer's disease, including the Alzheimer's Disease Research Center, and the Allen Institute for Brain Science, which is pushing the limits of technology and knowledge with respect to normal brain structure and function.
I think this is really a dream team to bring together to tackle this problem. It's essential to marry the basic research with the applied disease research, and we've got really world-class leaders on both sides of this to try to achieve these goals.
The point of this is to develop new knowledge that will allow researchers around the world to develop new treatments and ultimately, hopefully, develop a cure.